This weekend, the Heard Museum celebrates Hispanic culture with the Valley's only Spanish market featuring more than 70 artists. One of the artists that will be at the market is Larry Yanez. His artwork puts Hispanic tradition and popular culture together. Here now is Larry Yanez to talk about his work. Larry, you've been around the art scene in Arizona for a long time, but let's talk a little bit about your background. I know that, but our viewers don't. So.
No, I'm originally from Yuma. My mother and father were born in Yuma. I have a sister. I have to add that because last time she got angry at me for not including her in my comments.
That didn't happen on this show, though.
No, it was someplace else, yeah. So I have to include, but I have to include my whole family because they are, all my artwork is based on stories about the family.
And what got you started in the visual arts?
I was always doodling as a child. My parents taught me, my mother taught me how to draw, my father taught me how to color. My sister and I would spend days and times watching TV and going, oh, I can draw this character and stuff like this, and sharing information. My cousins, my uncles, everybody contributed to that and encouraged me to do it. We had no idea that you could actually do it for a living. So it was, well, that's something that the rich people do, you know, when they get your college degree and go on. And even going to college was not, you know, one of those things that they had thought about. And I was able to, you know, leave Yuma by way of the military, get that GI Bill, and go to school, get a degree in of all things, art, you know. So I've gone through the whole gamut of things when it comes to educational things.
And now you indicated that the inspiration for some of your work was growing up in Yuma with your family.
Yes.
and kind of the scenes. Explain that.
Oh, gosh, where can we start? I mean, I can start with the family, coming from a family of bilingual punsters. The things, as we see it now, the border
issues. And that's reflected in some of your work.
Yes, and a lot of the border issues that happens in Yuma. It's always been happening, so it's nothing new, all this stuff in the news. So, and the difference between Mexican-Americans and Mexicans, and, you know, and that whole society of cross-cultural living. To me, it was like becoming aware that my mother or any viejita would talk to me in Spanish and I would answer in English without thinking twice about changing languages in my brain. I was able to, and coming to think about when you...
Viejita, I mean older
old
woman,
folks,
yeah.
Any old folks.
Yeah.
I had an Anglo fan friend watching me speak to this guy for a half hour and he said, I only got half the conversation. He was talking to you in Spanish, you're answering in English, and you guys just went on for hours. What, you know, what's going on? And I went, oh my God, I never think about it. It's just one of those things that we do without thinking.
I want to talk some more about your art, but before we do that, where has it been exhibited, some of your major exhibitions? I know you're everywhere.
Phoenix Art Museum, Heard Museum, Museum for Youth, Mesa Museum for Youth, Tempe Art Center in the old days, it's a Smithsonian, Washington, D.C. There's a whole Los Angeles, Scotland. I've had some stuff touring through Europe. I can't keep track of everything because a lot of the artwork that I do have is in people's collections and they tour around to different places.
Oh. This is not a comment on your age, but you have been around a long time. What are you doing now? What's your principal focus?
My principal focus now is over for the Tempe Center for the Arts. I call myself the official picture hanger for the city of Tempe, but I do the installations, which is one of my great loves, is working with other people's artwork.
Anything particularly exciting that you're working on right now?
Oh, gosh. There's the next show. It's always the best one. So it's always exciting to take one down, put the next one up, and move along. I get to meet artists. I get to work with artists. I get to see new media. So it's like this great educational component that just lends itself to my own artwork. So I have the greatest teachers in the world constantly.
Now I know from my own personal experience, one of your most famous pieces is Cocina Haiteca. And that's recently been selected, as I understand it, for inclusion in the Smithsonian calendar, is that right?
Yes, it was for the year 2007. So
let's talk about the piece and then let's talk about its selection.
The piece was more or less a tribute to my grandmother, but
Cocina
it's all
meaning kitchen.
The kitchen, the cocina haiteca, and the haiteca is a Spanglish play on the word coming from the Native American tribes of Mexico, the Azteca, the Olmeca. So those that played with the computers and had high-tech things were, of course, haiteca. So that's that play on that word. So the cocina itself is basically a refrigerator that was purchased in the 50s and still works to this day. And so, you know, how high-tech can you get? I mean, if you look at it, there's a tube radio on top. And of course, my children don't know what tubes are because they're used to all this newfangled stuff. But it was under the table is where I would be playing with my little cars or trucks or drawing and listening to the family stories. So that has a lot, too. But it's like when you come to someone's kitchen, it's always, did you eat yet? Do you want to eat something? Here's some taquitos. We just made these. Or here's some fresh tamales. Try this out. So it was like this with our family. Is every time I went to another tia's house, another aunt's house, it was always about food. The whole family was about food. And that's, to me, that's Christmas. You know, you walk in the house, you can smell the tamales or the menudo. And it's the holidays. And my favorite joke is that at Thanksgiving, it's turkey tacos. All right. You know, look forward to that. Well, yeah.
Let's talk about how the piece was selected for inclusion in the Smithsonian calendar.
It was put together by the White Art Museum in Los Angeles for the KAET exhibit. And that was one of the first major Chicano exhibits. And how many years ago? I don't even remember. It just seems like the other day. And most of us, Martin Moreno, myself, Zarco, and a bunch of other people went to Los Angeles for
These
this huge
local
opening.
Local Arizona artists.
Yes. So we were part of and coming together with Chicano artists from all over the country. It was like a family reunion because we had known and admired all these other artists. And so we got to meet our heroes, some of the older veteranos from the 60s, you know, who were in that Chicano movement way back when. And it was quite an experience at that point. So the White Art Museum had commissioned Self-Help Graphics at that time as another nonprofit organization, very much like Mars and Chican Indio, to
the latter two being local self-help, local, being in,
yes,
in Los
exactly,
Angeles.
To promote, to have certain artists were chosen to come in and do a print, and we all submitted work, and mine was chosen. So I went and got to work with their printmaker, and 12 color print, and we did a limited edition of about 100. So each museum that this exhibit traveled to got one of those prints from each one of these artists.
And the Smithsonian just then decided to pick it for, yes, for its calendar.
Well, what happened is if they had the exhibit there, and at that time I was playing music with Carlos Nakai. And so Carlos Nakai and I, the group Jackalope, were invited to come and perform for the opening of the exhibit. So the whole thing just kind of came together. So it was Jackalope at the KAET exhibit in the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C.
Larry, we've got less than a minute left. One of the things we've been talking about with Chich Marin is Chicano art, Chicano artists. What's your view of Hispanic Chicano artists today?
We're getting better and better. And we're telling our stories, and our messages are getting out to more and more people. People are like, huh? They missed it in the 60s and are just now catching up with us. And it's that way with the arts. A lot of my stuff, like that print was done way back in 1989, it's now being recognized now. So, you know, it takes a little while.
Things are good.
Yeah, they're catching up.
Well,
they're catching
Yanez,
up with us.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank
on
you for
Horizonte.
Having me.
It's good to have you here. The Spanish Market is this weekend, November 10th and 11th at the Heard Museum in Phoenix at Central and Encanto from 10 to 5 p.m. on both days. Admission to the market is free. That's our show for tonight. Next Thursday on Horizonte, meet artist Daniel Martin Diaz. His latest collection of art, Mysterium Fidei, Mystery of Faith, is on display in Mesa. I'm Jose Cardenas. That's our show for this Thursday night. Thank you for joining us. Have a good evening.